If we zoom in here on our keyframes, you'll notice that there's a little blue icon at the very start of the graphic. You can actually click on this and it will actually create safe regions around your keyframes. Now you'll notice if we drag this out over the other clips and click back on the graphic, you'll notice that the keyframes are automatically adjusted for the new length of time. All right, so the next effect I use a lot is called dynamics. I use this a lot when it comes to voiceover or dialogue audio. So for example, here on my timeline, I'm gonna show you a clip without dynamics to just give you a baseline of what my raw audio sounds. For supporting me, new this month is a new text message bubble animation template for Premiere Pro. And to add dynamics to it, we're gonna go up to Audio Track Mixer, click the dropdown, go to Amplitude and Compression, and then click on Dynamics. Double click on the effect, and then what you'll want to do is check the box next to compressor, change the ratio to about 3 or so, and then you'll have to add some makeup, so go down there, add maybe 12, and then there's a limiter option to the far right bottom. You can check that box and make the limiter -6, that way you don't peak the audio. And now when we play this back, you'll see the difference here. Supporting me, new this month is a new text message bubble animation template for Premiere Pro. If you find yourself using B-roll clips a lot, you might want to consider using pancake sequences. What this allows you to do is have two sequences open at the same time. So for example, you can take your B-roll sequence, put it above your other sequence, scrub your B-roll sequence, find the clip that you want, and easily just click and drag it to your other sequence. And this is an easy way that you can add B-roll clips to your other timeline. Did you know there's a difference between applying an effect to the source and then the clip in the timeline? You'll notice when I did that, I'm actually affecting the clip in the timeline, not the actual source file. For example, if I go into another sequence here, you'll notice that this footage is placed in the timeline, then there's a B-roll shot, and then there's more footage. Now see what happens when I go into the source panel and I click auto. You'll notice that that effect is applied to this clip, but also the first clip in the timeline. The next tip is that you can go into your Premiere Pro preferences and under media cache, you can delete your media cache files. This will help clear some space inside your Premiere Pro project and help make it run faster. Now, if you want to automate this, you have some options down below that you can change. You can have it delete after a certain number of days or after it has built up to a certain gigabyte limit. Another option you can do is change your memory settings. You can decrease the value of reserved RAM for other applications. This way, Premiere Pro has more RAM that it can use to play back your footage. Say if you have a bunch of clips at the end of your sequence and you want to fade everything out, instead of trying to fade out all the clips, you can use what's called a black video. To create a black video, just click on your new item button in the project panel, then click on black video. Just make sure your sequence settings are correct and click OK, and next drag that new item to the end of your timeline. Then hit Command or Control D, and this will add the cross dissolve effect to it. And then just delete the end transition and trim it, and you'll notice that you have a nice fade out for the end of your sequence. This can also work for fading in your footage as well. So one of the most exciting new features is the updates to text-based editing. If you hop over from 2023 to 2024, you'll notice that there's a new filters button in the text panel. In here, you can select pauses. So when we click pause, what you'll notice is that all the pauses are selected in the timeline and in the text panel. Now next, what you can do is click delete, and then you can click the delete all button, and what will happen is you'll notice that it deleted all of our pauses in our Premiere Pro timeline.
You can use the remix tool to make a song inside Premiere Pro any length, whether you need it shorter or longer. You can see here on my timeline that I can't extend this clip to be the full length of my video. So if we use the remix tool, which is located underneath the ripple edit tool, you'll notice that we can extend the edge. So if we extend the edge, you'll notice that the essential sound panel will open up and Premiere Pro will automatically remix it to be the new length of time. Now you have some options here. You can change the amount of segments. So I recommend dragging it to the left to decrease the amount of times the music changes. If we zoom in and play it back, you can see where it changes by the squiggly.
Now, another thing that you might want to look at if you are, looking at different templates for Premiere Pro, maybe you want to replace the font for a lot of the different graphics inside Premiere Pro. For example, here, I have this party time graphic, but I also have this other graphic over here. What if I wanted to change the font for both graphics? Well, you can do this individually, but there's actually a way where you can change the fonts for your entire Premiere Pro project. To do that, go up to Graphics and Titles and go down to Replace Fonts and Projects. Then click on the font that you want to replace, and then choose the new font. We'll choose Big Caisson, click on the font, and then click OK. Then you'll notice that both graphics are updated with that new font. I don't like Big Caisson, so I'm going to hit Command-Z. I have a clip of a race car driver, and I want to add a pretty cool color grade to it. One of the top movies from last year was Top Gun Maverick. What if I wanted to copy the color grade from this clip? You can easily make a screenshot on your computer, click and drag it into your timeline as an image, and copy the grade from that image. To do that, in the timeline, click on the clip that you want to apply the grade to, and then in the Lumetri color panel, the section you want to go to is Color Wheels and Match. First, click on the Comparison View button. This will bring up two windows. Be sure that the reference monitor is over the clip that you want to copy the grade from. And then just be sure that your timeline playhead is over the clip you want to copy the grade to. Then click Apply Match. Adobe will then try to copy the grade from the original clip. Now this next tip is very handy if you add logos or bugs, as they call them, over your video. Essentially a logo graphic that lives in the bottom right corner of videos. Now you can do this by just adding a graphic inside your timeline, but you can actually do this on export in the export mode. So go to the Export tab, and the section you'll want to go to is actually the Effects tab. And then underneath Effects, you'll notice that there's an Image Overlay section. Click on it, and then you have an option to actually upload your bug file. So I'm just going to navigate to my logos, click on my bug file, and click Open. And you'll notice that Premiere Pro will add that file over my entire export duration.
So right now in my timeline, you'll notice that we added this music track, but it doesn't really mix well with my dialogue or voiceover. We need to adjust the audio levels, but we can automatically do that using the auto ducking feature. So to get started with the auto ducking feature, what we have to do is select the audio clips and assign them as dialogue. This way, Premiere Pro knows that those audio clips are dialogue pieces. So what I'm going to do is select my track forward select tool, hold down shift, and select all the clips on audio track 1. These are all my voiceover clips. Then, over in Essential Sound, I'm going to click the Dialogue button. This will tell Premiere Pro that these are our dialogue clips. Then what we can do is select the track and then check the box next to ducking. You'll notice that it will duck it around dialogue. So we have some options we can change down here. We can change the sensitivity, the duck amount, the fade duration, and the fade position. And then you can click Generate Keyframes, and this is how it sounds. How to use this template. Another tip is to use the paste attributes function inside Premiere Pro. For example, in my timeline here, I have a clip of this soccer player, and you'll notice that there are some bars on the top and bottom. I want to get rid of those and also get rid of them for the other clips in my timeline. In order to do that, I'll change the first clip and then copy the attributes of that clip. So to do that, I'm just going to go up to Edit, Copy, and then click on my other clip in the timeline, or if you have multiple clips, you can select all of them, and then go up to Edit, Paste Attributes. There are keyboard shortcuts for this as well if you just want to use your keyboard. This saves time because otherwise you'd have to do this manually every single time, and that's just tedious. What if I wanted to replace this clip in the timeline with a different B-roll clip? Well, what you can do is actually navigate to the footage, either in your source monitor or in your project panel, to the clip that you want to replace it with. Then you can right-click on the clip in the timeline and go to Replace with Clip from Bin or Source Monitor. I'm going to choose Bin, but as you can see, it updates in your Premiere Pro project. All right, the next one's a pretty cool effect. What if you wanted to actually put, you know, a piece of text inside a video? To do that, you can actually use the Track Matte key. Navigate to your Effects panel and type in Track Matte key. Click and drag this to the underlying video clip, and then go to Effects Controls. Then under Track Matte key, change the matte to Video 2, and just be sure Matte Alpha is selected. And then you'll notice that the party time graphic is within the underlying video clip. Another tip is when it comes to color grading. When I color grade my clips, I usually use adjustment layers. This does two things. First, it separates it from the video clip, so it doesn't bog down your video clip in the timeline. And second, it makes it more easy to edit later. So for example, if you use an adjustment layer, you can easily stretch that out over multiple clips and then use the razor tool to make a cut, and then just tweak your grade later on over different clips. Now this party time graphic is a little difficult to see. How can we actually make it pop from the background? What you can do is actually toggle the transparency grid. To do that, go to the wrench icon and then choose transparency grid. That's very helpful if you work with transparency a lot. So those are the 10 tips. Which ones did you not know? Leave your comments down below.
Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.